Hello there and welcome to the Critical Bench Compound. This is Coach Chris Wilson here with the one and only Michelle DiCapua, who is a favorite here, a regular guest at the compound. And today we are featuring and highlighting a few of the exercises from our very popular Unlock Your Glutes program. So we love talking about the butt. In fact, before we started rolling, we were talking about her butt and about activating her butt. And she's a CrossFitter. She's been doing CrossFit and figure competition for years and years and years. And she was told in competition that sometimes her weakest part of her physique,
my glutes,
was her glutes. So she started to work on them and put more emphasis on activating them and stimulating them when doing, you know, squats, when doing any exercise really that you're doing and for strength. Because the powerhouse of our body is the middle of our body, our hips and our butt, our hips and our glutes. That's where all of our strength, that's when we, you know, when we can, you know, pop those hips and when we're moving with a heavy weight, like a hinging weight, like deadlifting or kettlebell swings or, you know, power cleans or jerks or, I mean, just about any exercise, those, the hips are the center of it all. And the glutes help to extend, help to lock and extend the hip, right? So if you can't do a good job of squeezing your butt, or if you're not stimulating it enough and waking it up, then you're gonna have kind of a flat rear or just, it's like a sleeping butt, right? So what we wanna do is feature three things. One is an activating exercise, and then two more, one's gonna be body weight and one's gonna be with the equipment. These are all in the Unlock Your Glutes program. We'll talk to you more about that at the end. So first, Michelle, lay on your belly. You could just put your head rested on your arms. This is a very easy thing to do, but to start to wake up the butt. So all Michelle is gonna do right now is squeeze her glutes and raise her legs. And instantly you can see that she's activating her glute muscles. And she's just gonna do that for, you know, a brief period of time, 3-5 seconds, squeeze and hold. You can do them longer. You can do these for about 10 seconds with a couple seconds pause at the bottom and then squeeze again. And what we're starting to do is we're starting to circulate and stimulate the muscles, namely the glutes. We're also getting some hamstring. You're gonna feel some calves, but really the whole backside of the leg area is going. But all the magic is gonna happen in the butt, okay? So this is a really good exercise to start to waken things up a little bit for the, and it's just body weight, right? Easy to do, and there's different ways to do it, but this is a good starter way. Okay, so Michelle, come on up. So that is one of the activating exercises from Unlock Your Glutes. Then what we're gonna do from the one of the body weight routines, there are four workouts in Unlock Your Glutes. Two are body weight and two are the gym additions, which kind of involve body weight with gym equipment and or free weights. So she's gonna do one of the body weight exercises, which is just a single leg hip thrust. So the setup for the hip thrust is you wanna be sitting on the ground with for the single leg hip thrust, one leg is bent, flat foot, the other leg will actually end up going out straight. You're kind of comfortably pitched over the side of a bench with your chin kind of tucked towards your chest. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna elevate and activate, good. And then just down nice and slow under control, good. Try to keep that foot flat if you can, good. And then go ahead and lift, squeeze, and then down under control, good. So this is a single leg hip thrust. This is safe for the knees, and this does a fabulous job of getting that part of the body. So the left glute right now is highly activated and working really hard, but you're also secondarily, you're gonna hit your hamstrings, you're gonna feel your calf muscles, like your the lower part of the leg, because when you're just doing something with one side of the body, there's a lot of extra stuff that has to happen for you to feel like you can hold the position and stabilize yourself. So this is single leg hip thrust. Go ahead and do like 4 or 5 on the other leg too, so you don't feel so lopsided, right? I don't want her going home with her left glute muscle feeling all swollen. And you can get a good shot too with the camera at this angle too, just to see what's happening. So notice her control. She's not rushing through this. She's really taking her time. She's doing a nice pause at the top. And she's really starting to like have that mind-muscle connection with a body part that, for her, she was underdeveloped and not activating. Good. Make sure you go all the way down, in between, all the way down. Good. And then one more. And you're probably really feeling, you're feeling that now. Is that the side hip that yeah. kind of bugs you? Good. Go ahead and relax. So she, again, she's really strong. She's highly active. And she does a lot of full body movements, but even something like that with body weight, you feel it because it's a bit of a like a weak spot for you. Your hips can be, you know, pinchy and a little chronic, like tight and impinged and stuff, right?
So and my glutes were never where they needed to be.
They're not where they needed to be. So that's what we're doing with this program. We're unlike because. What this program is trying to teach people is that squats and deadlifts and lunges, those aren't actually the best movements when you're targeting the butt. If you're going after the butt, you need to wake the butt up and stimulate the butt with lots of other, you know, because the glutes are designed to move your legs like away from midline and to do a lot of stuff that squats, deadlifts, and lunges aren't doing for you. So speaking of that, actually what we're going to do now is we're going to come on up. And we're gonna go to a gym exercise using just lightweight, and I'll move the bench out of the way just a little so you don't kick it. This is actually a partial single leg squat. But because it's on a single leg, there's a lot going on. So are you gonna start with your strong leg or your weaker leg?
This is my better leg.
Okay, so Michelle's gonna start on her left leg, which she feels more stable on. Okay, so go ahead and do that. And looking forward, so it's less of a deadlift and more of a squat. So like kind of more look forward, more knee bend, and less good. Looking forward, bend the knee, partial squat. Good. So just try to keep, now try to do it with keeping the chest a little bit more upright as you go. Yes. And back up. So it's just like the top portion of a squat. Single leg. Good. That is better. So see how she corrected herself? She was doing a little bit too much hip hinge. Now she's doing a little bit more bend from the knee. Good. So we're working at the top portion of the squat on just one leg, and that's where the glute is really coming into play. Did you feel that?
Yes.
Okay, so go to the other leg now. I wanna clarify something as we're teaching this, because most people think, oh, squats equals better glutes, equals a rounder, stronger butt. No, but the butt is involved in the squat, and guess where? At the top of the motion, at the top of the squat. So as you notice, Michelle's having more trouble on her right leg. It's not her typical stabilizing leg. I'm sure if you were to kick a ball, you'd kick it with your right foot, which means her left leg is her better leg at holding her, at grounding herself. Before she would kick. I'm the same way. My left leg, I feel more balanced and sturdy on than my right leg. Go ahead and just do one more, looking forward. So what she's doing is she's doing a little bit more of like a kickstand approach, where she's kind of like letting her trailing leg just like touch the ground as she's trying to still do the partial squat. So it's like good, and go ahead and rest. So it's like you're getting a little bit of like assistance, so to speak, like a spotter by having that toe trail behind you. So again, I wanted to clarify, thank you so much. I wanted to clarify something that's really important, is that the squat is good when done certain ways to stimulate the glutes, like that. Single leg, partial squat, focused on the top. Everything from like here down in a squat, or I should say maybe from here down, this is all quad. All quad. This is all quad right here for squats. That's glutes. So the glutes is just the top of the squat where you extend the hip and squeeze the butt. So that's why squats aren't the answer. The hip thrust that you really, really felt, the first move that we did with body weight, that's the answer.
So I'm still feeling all of this.
I know. We're waking them up. We're talking to them. And that's the whole idea with the program is, we're putting your butt, your buns, into gear, and we're giving you the best tools to stimulate, to get blood flow in there, to, you know, reach those muscles that are sometimes hard to reach with traditional exercises. So you have to start to do other stuff. That's just a little bit of what's in the glutes program. Bam! Unlock your glutes. So, I know, I'm trying to be silly. This is the program Unlock Your Glutes. And again, we featured three exercises that you will see and do inside the program. It's really good because, as I've said this whole video, it's about activating and doing more atypical or unusual movements that you don't see a lot of people doing. With body weight, with bands, with dumbbells, with cables, with all kinds of stuff. And it's all in the Unlock Your Glutes program. Very, very good program. Again, it's two body weight routines and two gym routines. So there are two routines you can do at home with no equipment at all. And there's two routines where you would need access to some stuff like dumbbells or mini bands or maybe a glute ham raise machine or something like that. That would be at a typical gym. So a terrific program. Check the pinned comment down below. If you're looking for a rounder, stronger butt, the only way to do it is with the right movements, okay? Because some of us are not blessed, you know, with the big, round, strong glutes.
I have to work for it.
So, and that's, you know, that's, I don't know anybody that wants the flat, weak butt, you know? So. Please go check that program out in the pinned comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to give Michelle a great big thumbs up. Subscribe to the Critical Bench YouTube channel for more content like this. Leave us a comment or question down below about your butt or about glute training in general, any questions that you might have. And thanks, and we'll see you again real soon.